So it's actually Brad Malt, who handles all of their blind trusts, as they're called, and handles all of their investments, is on the phone right now talking to reporters. And he's actually saying to call these overseas accounts is not right. These are funds. He's got all kinds of foreign stocks, American stocks, foreign bonds, American bonds. But he has accounts that are third-party funds, he calls them, organized in the Cayman Islands, also Bermuda. We know as well in here that there was at one point, I think in 2010, a Swiss bank account that has since been closed. But, you know, people are looking at these, especially people who are opponents, people who like to talk about income inequality, and they're looking at all these, looking for any of those signs that somehow, you know, he's getting an upper hand in the American economy. But what the campaign is saying and what these documents so far are showing is that he is, by the book, to the letter, following the law. The question is, what is the tax law, the tax code? It's very big, very complicated. So that's where they stand on these foreign funds in particular.
Okay. Are we going to go to some sound there or no?
Well, yeah, let's go to the sound, because Earlier David K. Johnson was he's got a Pulitzer Prize. He's a Reuters columnist, very well known on tax issues. He was pointing out something. He noted that there was money, no gift tax, money that Mitt Romney was able to give with no tax, basically to a family trust, and that had raised some eyebrows and raised some hackles from people. But it's all fair. It's all legal. Well, if it's fair is one thing. It's legal. This is what David K. Johnson said.
It's absolutely legal. The scandal here is not the Romneys who have complied with the law in every way. It is the law that requires you and me to be taxed differently and much more heavily than a very small group of people, those who run funds of the kind that Mr. Romney did.
You know, what he's talking about is people who are the very top of the 1%, who make money with money. I mean, Mitt Romney is not getting earnings from his work. He's getting earnings from his money, and that's taxed at a lower rate than if you go out and you actually work. And that's part of the issue here, that people at the very top end, the money they're making from their money, they're being taxed at a much lower rate on it.
Now, if you look at all the 1040s, there's a lot of quite a difference here. If you were to take Obama, Gingrich, and Romney, quite a difference, but really no surprise.
Right, I think you're right, and let's just look at that difference, because you can see that the Romneys, their total income in 2010 was like $21 million. They paid $3 million in taxes, almost 14% for a tax rate. You look at the Gingriches, for example, they paid they earned about $3 million. They paid almost $1 million in taxes. Their tax rate, effective tax rate, is higher, about 31%. And then look at the Obamas, $1.7 million total taxes, less than $500,000 and a 26% tax rate. All of these people, by the way, are way better off than the average American. I mean, the average family income is something like $49,000 a year, median income rather, and has been slowly declining. So there's a whole discussion here about who runs for office. I mean, whether you have $1 million a year, I mean, $21 million a year, seriously, is an awful lot of money. That's a lot of money that that they made last year. The Romneys certainly puts them in the very top echelons of earners in this country, but certainly puts all of the players in politics way out of the reach of the average American.